So now the most important question, okay? What do you think about French people?
Hello, how are you?
I'm good.
What you doing?
Looking at the weather, isn't it nice?
It's nice. Like rain?
I do, but not when I'm outside and have no umbrella.
Salut à tous les amis, alors dans la vidéo d'aujourd'hui, nous allons parler d'un sujet important, ce sont les études universitaires, la question de l'emploi aussi un petit peu en Thaïlande. Et pour ce faire, j'ai invité Nida qui est une amie thaïlandaise. Sawadee khap. Bienvenue, welcome. Ok, alors elle parle très bien anglais, donc on va parler en anglais, on va faire cette interview en anglais. So we can make it in English, right?
Yes.
Or in French, you want to?
Please.
In English, okay, no worries, okay. So maybe to start, you can tell us some stuff about you.
Okay, I'm Nida. I'm Thai, and I was born and raised in Bangkok.
Okay, so you are a Bangkok girl, right?
Yes, I am.
Okay, so, but you travel sometimes in the provinces or not? Do you have family in provinces?
No, all my family is in Bangkok.
In Bangkok.
But I do travel outside of Bangkok.
Okay, good. So what do you like to do when you have free time here in Bangkok? What can you do like?
Recently, I take on wakeboarding as my activity, my hobbies.
Okay, like surfing, right?
Almost, but it's okay. Like surfing in a lake.
Okay, so the topic of this video will be the studies, education system in here in Thailand. So where did you study?
I studied my bachelor and master in Thammasat University.
Thammasat University,
yes.
Okay. So can you tell us a bit about this university?
Well, it's considered to be the famous university in Thailand. It is famous on their business faculty and of course law faculty also. And along with that, there are Chulalongkorn University and Mahidol University, which is famous for their medicine faculty.
So why did you choose Thammasat University?
So I chose Thammasat University because of its political history, and second of all is near my house, and the most important one is I got a full scholarship there.
Oh, you got scholarship there, okay.
Yes.
What about the history? You say political history, what do you mean?
If you know about the Thai politics, right?
Yeah.
You will know that Thammasat students usually protest to get the democracy.
Oh, okay. Yes. So this university actually is famous about law,
yes.
Right? Oh, okay. Okay. So the other question, how did you get admitted there? Like based on have to pass the exam or is the high school results?
For me, I have to take an admission exam.
Yeah.
And then submit that result to the university.
Okay.
But there are also many ways to get admitted to the university. You can use your admission result and then your high school grade for the
okay. So yeah, don't worry, everything's okay. So you ever been abroad?
Yes.
Which country?
I just came back from Italy.
Italy?
Yes,
okay.
I did an exchange semester in Milan.
Oh, cool. Like you spent like 6 months there?
No, I was supposed to spend like 6 months there, but because of COVID, I only spent 2 months
okay,
there.
Okay, just 2 months, unfortunately, yeah. Okay. Any other countries before?
Well, I've been to US.
US, okay. So which one is your favorite between US and Europe?
Oh, I love the US.
You love the US,
yes,
okay.
Yes, but I would like to explore Europe for sure.
Okay. Okay, next question is where do you see yourself in the next 5 years?
Well, that's a hard question. I'm I would see myself working in a corporate world still, so not so different from now, but I would like to be working abroad.
Abroad?
Yes.
Okay. So you don't see yourself in Thailand anyway, Shamai?
No, I want to explore the world.
Okay. So what about your family life, family perspective? What do you think? You will be married here, or you want to spend single life, or how do you see yourself?
I want to one day be married, but I'm not sure when.
Yeah. But you want to live abroad?
Yes, I want to live abroad for sure.
Okay. So now the most important question, okay? What do you think about French people? Honestly, it's okay. You can say everything, no worries.
Honestly. I don't want to offend any of you, but...
Yeah? What do you think about reputation, I mean?
They are really very flirty and like...
Oh, French people really flirty, right?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
And they are considered to not be monogamy, which I...
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. So that's what you're hearing about French people, right?
Yes, and that's okay. What I have experienced so far.
Oh, really? Okay. So, like, you studied 5 years in total in Thammasat University?
6 years.
6 years,
yes.
Actually. Okay. So how hard it is to pass every year exam, you know?
It is very hard. And I remember I spent time at university until midnight for like weeks.
Oh, really?
To do like group project there and like study together with friends.
So you have time, free time to enjoy your life during your studies or not? Or not too much?
Very little time to enjoy my life. But I mean, I was happy to spend it with my classmates.
Okay. So any time to have a boyfriend or something, or it's like really...
It's not that bad.
It's not that bad.
It's not that bad.
Okay. What topics did you study?
In my bachelor, I studied accounting, and in my master, I studied finance.
Finance, okay.
Yes.
And then, how did you find the first job? How did you become a consultant?
Well, I just searched for it in a job website. It's that easy.
Okay.
And it's a very good job in an international company, like with international culture.
And you are international culture, right?
Yes.
You ever worked for a Thai culture company or not?
No, but I use... no, not really.
Never?
Never.
Okay. So, would you like to experience that or not?
I don't think so.
You want like international company?
Yes.
Okay. So, your English is really impressive, actually, to be honest.
Thank you.
So, how did you learn English? I think, yeah, the audience would like to know, how did you learn your English?
I learned since a young age.
Yeah?
I used to have a Falang as my neighbor, and my mom hired him to teach us English when we were young.
Oh, okay. So your family hired the like foreigner?
Yes.
That's good.
But also in school help a lot.
Yeah. So you put a lot of efforts to learn English, to speak, like to get your actual level, right?
Yes, but I kind of keep it casual. I watch lots of movies, listening to like many music.
Yeah. So you are not the type of girls who watching like a Korean series or stuff like this?
I do watch that.
You watch,
but,
right?
But English series more.
English series.
American series.
Okay. And did you ever consider learning French language?
I did, but it never took off.
What can you say in French?
Bonjour.
Bonjour, ça va? Tu vas bien? Repeat after me. Tu vas bien?
Ça va bien.
Tu fais quoi demain? Tu fais quoi demain? Puni tamarai. Tu fais quoi demain?
Tu fais quoi demain?
Tu as déjà mangé?
That's too hard.
Tinkao Leyang. Tu as déjà mangé?
Tu as déjà mangé.
Yes, good. Do you have brother and sisters?
I have 2 sisters.
Oh, really? What are they doing? Older or youngest?
Both. I'm the middle child.
Oh, good. So what are they doing, your sisters?
So one of them is a doctor in Bangkok. Another one just graduated from a law school.
Oh, good. You said you were a Bangkok girl. So how? What difference there is between someone who grew up in Bangkok or and another girl who grew up in province?
In that part, I cannot really say, but I think I'm sophisticated to a city life more than a girl from, or people from, like, suburban.
Okay. And in Thammasat University, from what social class your friends coming from? Mm-hmm. Any social class? Every social class? Or, like,
yeah, every you can... Every social class. I have like a friend who is like, wow, very rich, like driving a Ferrari to the university. And then there's someone who doesn't have much as the others. But we all get along. It's not about money or anything.
Really?
Yes.
Okay, so yeah. But mostly people in Tamasat, it's like high level, high social class or not?
No, I would like to say middle class, the up middle class and upper middle class. Mm.
Is it the same for Mohidol and Shula Lontorn University?
I think it's the same. Okay, but there are some like faculty in Tamasat or even Mohidol or Shula is an international faculty, and in those faculties is usually like the one with rich family, because the tuition fee is like so expensive. Like some are more than 100k per semester.
Oh, that's a lot. That's a lot. So what about, I heard like many Thai people moving to study abroad too.
Yes.
Like getting degree in USA and then coming back here.
Yes.
So is it something special common here in Thailand?
It's,
of rich people sending their children to study abroad and coming back here?
Yeah, it's quite common, but usually they do it for their master. People will go to England to have their degree because it's their master degree, because it takes only a year to get a master degree there.
Oh, okay. But others choose USA?
Yes, some.
Okay. So, what's the perceptions between people who studies abroad and the ones who studied like in Thailand? Yeah, regarding the first application for a job.
Okay, if it's an application for a first job, I would say that people who graduated abroad will be perceived with higher value than people who graduated from university in Thailand. But for the job after that, I don't think it matters that much. It's more about the job experience.
Job experience matters, right? Okay, so when you like graduating from the top three universities in Thai, what can you expect as first salary? As first salary? Yeah, we know that people working in 7-Eleven have like 10,000 baht, 12,000 baht. But people in those top three universities, what's between, just range?
Okay, it would be more than 25k.
To start, 25k is right?
Yes.
Okay.
More than that. But it's also different from for the industry and for the faculties that you graduated in. And also your ability to speak the second language and third languages also.
Oh, okay, so it's many, okay. You mentioned that you have studied in Italy, and what comparison can you make between your studies in Italy and compared to Thai studies?
I think we have more of a quiz and exam over here, but in Italy it is so intense as well, and people is like so individual. Over here in Thailand, we study as a group after class together to help each other, you know. But in Italy, maybe because I got there for not so long, so it's more like individual, to be honest.
Would you consider one day to live in France?
I would.
Really?
Yes.
Why? Give me some reasons. I would like to know why.
Like I told you, I would like to explore the world, and France is like a good place, and I just watched Emily in Paris, so.
Oh, okay, the series Emily in Paris.
Yes.
Right? Okay. So can you tell me what you know about France? I know you've never been for now, but what do you know? What's your perception about France?
Good food.
Good food. Okay, give me what food? What do you know?
Croissant.
Croissant. Yeah. Okay. Croissant. Then. What do you know?
They eat snails, you guys.
Snails.
Snails.
Snails. Les escargots, yeah. Because you say this, saying this because we just saw a snail here, right?
No.
Okay, snails, yeah. And then? What do you know
champagne.
Else? Champagne. Champagne, yeah, okay. French is about wine too, you know? Wine.
Oh,
yeah,
really?
It's fine. Yeah, wine is like French's famous one in the world. Do you know macaron? I think like I interviewed some Thai people, they mostly talk about macaron. Yeah. They know three things about Thai people. Know three things. They know macaron, Eiffel Tower, and croissant. Mm. Yeah. So you said the one. Yeah. And what city do you know about France?
Paris.
Paris, yes.
Toulouse.
Toulouse, yeah. Good, good. How do you know that?
Because I was picking between doing an exchange semester in Milan and Toulouse.
Oh, okay. Yeah. So you had choice between Italy and France, right?
Yes, and many other countries.
Okay, so why did you choose like Italy compared to France, for example?
Because it's in the middle of Europe. I wanted to travel, like where I studied there.
Come on, it's near France, just near.
Yeah, but like, there are so many attractions in Italy. I'm sorry, guys.
Désolé pour vous. Yeah, no worries. You will come back, right?
Yeah, of course, definitely.
Okay. Yeah. Thank you so much for your time today, and I hope to see you again soon.
Yeah, sure.
Merci beaucoup.
Merci beaucoup.
Thank you. Prenez soin de vous, les amis, et je vous dis à très bientôt. Ciao, ciao.